okay? But for you, of course, if your husband is not here, don't talk about that, okay? You can talk when you go home. There is rampant greed and dishonesty. Well, actually, greed and dishonesty, sometimes you already have so many, and yet you are not happy. So even if you have something already, you try to be dishonest of something so you can get more, no? Parang kunyari, yung mga contract, magbabribe ka pa para makuha mo pa yung another contract or something like that. Actually, in my work, okay, I work in some offshore engineering company. I was wondering if my boss is doing that thing. Because sometimes, I mean, like, there are cases when you're supposed to be bidding, hindi mo dapat tinatawagan yung kliyente. Everything is supposed to be through, like, a proper channel, like. But sometimes, the client would call us and looking for my boss. And since I am the assistant on the bid, everything comes to me, like, at sabi ko, nagbabribe kaya itong amo ko? Bakit sabi ko, tinatawag na siya ng kliyente eh? Hindi pa naman na-declare na kami yung winner, di ba? But you see, in our company, there is that bribery act that you are not supposed to be. So I hope this. Okay. Workaholics leaving no room for God. Sometimes we are like that, no? Trabaho tayo ng trabaho, overtime tayo ng overtime, nakalimutan na natin si Lord who is supposed to give us more abundance. Diba? Sabi nga niya eh. In one of the passages of the Bible, okay, sinasabi doon, na pagka ikaw ay tumawag sa kanya at humingi, ikaw ay kanyang pagbibigyan. Eh kung trabaho ka ng trabaho, paano ka makakatawa? The others would say, oh, we have the direct line to God, so we don't have confession. But that's not the case. Because when Jesus has anointed his apostles, he said, whoever you forgive, they are forgiven. And those you retain, they are retained. So yung mga nagsasabi dyan sa inyo na hindi na kailangan ng confession sa pare, they'll think again. Because it is not. Unless, of course, you don't believe. Because you are not Catholics. But as Catholics, that is the book, what the Bible says. Now, alarming breakup of families due to lack of commitment of spouses. Ngayon, ito sasabihin ko sa inyo. Sino sa inyo dito mga handmaids ang merong asawa? They're just from back home, or they're from work. That's why you're thinking for handmaids, or one way or another. Okay? Sa atin, kasi even sa atin, no, we said that Philippines is a Catholic country. In fact, Pope John Paul II visited us twice, di ba? During his tenure na Pope. Dahil Pilipinas lang daw ang Catholic country. But come to think of it, how many do you know ang naghihiwalay na ang mag-asawa? Or we are calling here about somebody or about living in sin. Actually, nung araw, they call it living in sin. Pero ngayon, hindi na, tinanggal na yung sin. Living in na lang. You see, kahit na ano pang gawin mo, without the blessing of the church, ay kasalanan pa rin yun. So if you have something like that, as we go along, you will see that there will be really a need for you to get something done right. Okay? So spiritual blindness giving rise to man-made religions and cults. Actually, ako hindi ko masyadong alam eh, but they're talking about, ano ba yun? New Age something. I don't know what they are or whatever they are. Something na, kunyari, meron lang nag-preach, narinig nila maganda, nakinig na sila, and they form a community or something, so something like that. Well, Coffers for Christ actually is the same. But the thing is, we never really branch out of the church. Okay? So, Couples for Christ, Handmaids of the Lord, or Servants of the Lord, we are still part of the Church of God. So, whatever doon sa mga naririnig nyo na ano, at may mga kaibigan kayo, try to tell them or encourage them to go back to the Church. Because that is what God has promised. Right. So, why are Christians behaving like this in the modern world? Okay. We call it economic hard times. Yung sabi nila, dahil mahirap ang buhay, kahit ano, pwede na lang. Yung bang parang gano'n. But pagkatingnan mo, actually those who really say that, things will become more difficult para sa kanila. Because in the first place, parang yung mali, dinagdagan pa ng another mali. So in the process, instead na mapabuti, lalo pang napasama, di ba? Yung ganun. So for you, mga sisters, is I all welcome you to the Christian Life Program. And I hope and pray all of us here for the team, you will find Jesus and what you're really looking for as you continue with the Christian Life Program. Okay. The other reasons, sociological reasons. Ano ba yung mga sociological reasons natin? Okay. There are times, okay, when we resort to like alcohol, we resort to drugs, dahil nakikisama ka eh, parang gano'n. Kung nakisama ka, so parang ginagawa nila, gawin mo na rin. Parang gano'n. Or it's just a solution to your problem na nakikita mo. The thing is, actually for us Christians or Catholics, we're not supposed to run away from the problem. Dahil pagka tumakbo ka, hahabulin ka nun. Where you are, the problem will still remain. So actually, you have to face it and put a solution into it. Alam mo? Ganun yung siya. Ang problema, hindi yun nawawala. Unless and until you have to face it and try to fix it. Face and fix. Ganun yun. So hindi yun siya. Actually, yung mga reason ng iba is just like, just an escape. Yung parang just an escape of the way out. Yung gano'n na kalimutan mo na yung tama, basta maka ano ka lang na solusyon sa problema. Marami sa mga kababayan natin, no? Dito. In fact, when we talk about yung pagpunta dito sa Dubai, normally ang reason is ano? For the family. Ang normal na ano is for the family, para mapaganda yung buhay. But didn't you realize na marami sa mga nagpunta ang mga pamilya sa atin na hindi naman ganun na nangyari. The family has broken up, di ba? Marami. Yung naiwan sa Pilipinas, instead na galagaan ng bata or somebody sa pamilya, sa mga magulang, nung nakatikim ng pera na masagana, parang yung values nakalimutan na rin. That is one of the things of us being here. Kaya pagka nagdadasal kayo, don't forget to pray for your family. Always pray for those. Especially, also pray for the sakitumas. Kaya maganda itong ating ano. When we come to this, okay. Patapit ko yan. It's okay. What does history say? Okay? When we are talking here about why Christians are behaving like this in the modern world, what was Christians' attitude like then? Alam niyo doon sa Acts of the Apostles, there was this, after the resurrection of Jesus, okay, the apostles became so bold about proclaiming the word of God. Okay? In fact, si Pedro, si Saint Peter, they said, is the most unstable of Jesus' apostles. Pero tingnan niyo, when the apostles have lived, okay, parang nagbubutuhan yung mga yan eh. Sino ang lahat, parang leader sa lahat ng apostles ni Jesus? Saint Peter, di ba? In fact, the Saint Peter is the one which our Pope is holding. Siya yung tagapagmana ng baston ni Pedro. Yan, si Pope. But Saint Peter is the... How many times niyang dininay si Jesus during the Passion? Three times. How many times siya nag-ano na mga kwan ni Jesus na sabi niya, oh Lord, kung nandiyan ka sa tubig, naglalakad, papuntahin mo ako dyan. Excited din siya, di ba? But in the middle of it, nag-falter yung kanyang faith. So nagsimula siyang lumubog. Anong sabi ni Jesus? You man of little faith. Pero hindi niya sinabi ni little faith. That's how it is. But you see, Peter is the one who heads the 12 apostles. Siya yung leader. Okay? During the time na nag-resurrection si Jesus, they were already proclaiming the words boldly. Because they have learned Jesus is alive. Si Peter, ano ang kanyang profession? Fisherman. Normally, pagka-fisherman ka, ano? Wala kang pinag-aralan. But when he stand in front of proclaim the word of God to all those people around him, how many people were converted to Christianity? 3,000. On that day, 3,000 were converted to Christianity by the very word of this fisherman who is of little faith. Why is that so? During the time of the first history of the Christians, okay, lahat ng mga Kristiyano, okay, kung meron sila mga ari-arian, ibibenta nila yun. Ibibigay lahat ng napagbentahan sa mga apostoles. Yung mga apostoles ay magdi-distribute kung para kanino yung bawat ano blessing. Kunyari, ikaw anim ang anak mo, kung 2 times 6 yung multiplier ng ano. Kunyari, ilan tayo dito? 100? Okay, divide mo 100 sa kanya times 6 kasi yung anak niya 6 or yung tatlo, mas kukunti. Ganun yung ginagawa nila. Those were the ones what the early Christians are doing. But what about today's Christianity?
Some of them.
In fact, pagka ginawa yun ni Father Tom, before tayo magdi-distribute sa lahat ng Pilipino, baka next year na tayo abutin. Diba? Did you go to church recently? During the pastoral visit, okay, it is being announced yung collection during the Holy Week. O yung brown envelope, is actually pick up but anyone who comes to the church and bring it on Good Friday. How much is the collection?
1.2
million dirhams. Oh. I-convert mo yun ng pesos. That is around, ano? 14 million. 14 million, around 14 million 400,000 something something. Okay? And those, they have to distribute. Meron para sa Pope, meron para sa Jerusalem, meron para sa Bishop, and meron para sa Church. Recently, merong ano? Recently ba yun? O hindi pa nangyayari? There are those yung ano, yung para sa mga housemaids. Binibigay ng sibahan, you have a free tour of Dubai, every lunch, and mingle with the other sisters.
Last Friday.
Okay, last Friday. So that's also part of your love offering sa sibahan. Binibigay muli ng sibahan. Those mga nangyari doon sa Hayan, sa Tacloban, the church has given there. So pagka merong mga ganong ano, na hindi naman lahat inano, it's being used for the mission. Okay? So if you become generous, kung sino man na nagpunta sa mission, kasama kayo doon dahil nagbigay kayo. Ngayon, kung binuksan nyo yung pera, asa susunod ka lang kayo magbigay. Kasi, marami pa rin naman susunod. You go to mass every day, or every Sunday, or every Friday. Whatever is there, don't forget that what you give, what the church does, ginawa nyo na rin yun. Dahil kasama kayo doon sa mga nagbigay. Yung mga bata nga sa catechism, they only give one dirham. But I tell them, na what the church does, your one dirham goes a long way. Dahil sa mga bata yung binigyan nila is for the Syrian children, they were able to collect some 30,000, I think, something. Sa mga bata lang yun, ha? Of course, hindi galing yun sa bursa nila, kundi hiningi sa mga nanay at tatay, di ba? But that's how generous people are. That's a part of being the first history Christians. Okay. And we can do a lot more. Now, what is Christianity today? Tingnan natin. Christianity today lack in spiritual power as Christians. Why? Because we are not willing to give up sin. Our conversion to the Lord is not full. and we have no personal relationship with Jesus. Actually, you're unwilling to give up sin. How do you know that you have committed the sin? Alam mo yung napanood, yung pinapanood minsan ng mga bata, no? Minsan nakikinood ako sa anak ko eh. Pinapanood niya cartoons. Okay. Yung character, yung, ano ba yun? Sa, yung, may Muffet siya eh. Yung si Jiminy Cricket, yung conscience. Actually, one of the characters there is Jiminy Cricket. It is his conscience. Pinocchio. Pinocchio is actually a wooden puppet. Okay? And he keeps committing of sin. Pupunta siya sa school, nagsaside entrance, he went somewhere else. Doon sa may mga palaro. Yeah. Instead na, kasi yung kanyang tatay, he is, tawag nito, yung nagtutuwa ng mga puppet, mga wooden things. So, inano niya to si Pinocchio na pumunta sa school. Si Pinocchio, instead na pupunta sa school, pumunta siya doon sa may parang mga merry-go-round, mga playground, gano'n. Ang kaso meron siyang konsensya who keeps reminding him na mali yung ginagawa mo. Okay. That for us, okay, it will be difficult for us to know that we are sinners if we are in sin itself. Unless and until you know na si Jesus is your Lord and Savior. Kasi, when you say, my Jesus is my Lord and my Savior, you learn how to surrender. And in that way, every time you commit a sin, yung consciousness mo, yung tinatawag natin conscience, sasabihin ko sa'yo, maririnig mo yun siya. As in, literally, maririnig mo. Yung conscience mo, you will not hear it. Pero, as you go along like this, hearing teachings, reading Bibles, and something else, okay, about God's Word, or makinig ka sa Misa, or even the homily, okay, your consciousness about sin, ay maririnig.